تنمي وانا put a paper. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله الذي جمعنا على محبة الله ومحبة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وعلى محبة أولياء الطريقة النقشبندية العلية الذين هم أمراء المسلمين. I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gathered us on the love of Awliya al-Tariqa al-Naqshbandiya, the saints of the Naqshbandi order. They are the princesses and they are the kings of the world, of the Muslim world. Because their love relate to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so extensively. So we say, Ya Sayyidi Ya Rasulallah, يا سيدي يا حبيب الله، أنت ناظرنا وأنت شاهدنا. You are seeing us. You are listening to us. You are witnessing us. We cannot do anything. We are weak servant. يا سيدي يا رسول الله، منك البركة ومنك الدعاء ومنك الرحمة. الرحمة التي رحمك الله بها. The mercy that Allah has dressed on you, the mercy that Allah make every possible creation on the world to exist. My tongue is frozen when it comes to speak about Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam seeking the beloved. It's not an easy word, seeking the beloved. Everyone has to seek the beloved, or else he is not able to go through paradise. The beloved is in Arabic Habibullah. You can say Muhammad Habibullah, and you can say Habibullah Muhammad. Muhammad Habibullah. وحبيب الله ومحمد. But you cannot say إبراهيم حبيب الله. It doesn't work in Arabic grammar. You can say خليل الله. Only محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم is the حبيب. No one else. That's why Imam Al-Busayri said وكل من رسول الله ملتمس غرسا من البحر او رشفا من الديم. Everyone is seeking and taking from Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Either by a picture or by hand, that knowledge, that water, that fountain of youth, that سيدنا الخضر عليه السلام and ذوالقرنين were competing for it. And they said Sayyidina al-Khidr took the water of youth and he was able to drink it. But if we go back to the ayah which was before mentioned, that فَوَجَدَا عَبْدًا مِّنْ عِبَادِنَا آتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِنَا وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّ عِلْمًا. Allah said, when he ordered Musa to look for someone, and it was a test for Sayyidina Musa, because what he did to get that test, big test, that he is in need to hear Sayyidina al-Khidr alayhi salam, although he is higher in level. What was the test? Because he gave a lecture, a nasiha, advice, in front of many Jewish people at that time. In front of many people at that time. And one of the ulama that was there came to him, and Musa said, how was my lecture? He wants to show him that I did something great. I gave a very nice lecture, everyone was motivated with it. So that alim kept quiet. Allah tested him, Sayyidina Musa. Ya Musa, you are in need for a knowledge that you don't know. That I didn't show it to you. If I will show it, you will know it. But I put it with that one who was looking for the water of use. فَوَجَدَ عَبْدًا مِّنْ عِبَادِنَا. They found one servant of many. Many servants. We gave him rahmah. Then we taught him divine knowledge. I'm trying to cut, summarize. If he didn't give him rahmah, he would never enter the ocean of the divine presence, of the divine knowledge. That's why rahmah came before. أَتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِنَا. We gave him a rahmah from ourselves. وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا عِلْمًا. At that time we taught him the knowledge that he needs to know. The secret knowledge, the divine knowledge. Who is that rahmah? And every one of you knows that rahmah is Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why he was able to enter the divine knowledge with the rahmah of Prophet, with the dress of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he dressed him with. Allah dressed Prophet, Prophet dressed Khidr alayhi salam. He entered in the divine knowledge. That's why he knew what happened. And he told Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, إِنَّكَ لَن تَسْتَطِيعَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا. You cannot continue with me. You cannot be patient with me. Wait until I tell you what everything is, what I am doing. This awliya Allah here, or our sheikh, or our grand sheikh, or our shuyukh, and all Naqshbandis, and all tariqats, are the door of rahmatullah, because they are the lovers of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rasulullah. Cutting it short, he went on the boat. And he took something and begin to open a hole in the boat. And they were looking, what he is doing? Sayyidina Musa looking, what he is doing? Why you are opening a hole in the boat? You are going to sink the boat and everyone going to die. He says, didn't I tell you you cannot carry on with me? What was that boat? What was that boat and what he, Khidr alayhi salam, was doing? The boat, the child, the world. The story, you know it. But what was that boat? Why he is opening a hole in the boat? Means he is opening a hole, as we can understand from Abu Yazid al-Bastami, that all of Tariqa Naqshbandiya, they take from him. He said, Ya Rabbi, كيف الوصول إليك? How I can reach you? He said, اترك نفسك وتعال. Leave your ego, leave yourself away and come to me. You cannot come to me with your ego. Any sheikh or any murid who doesn't listen to his peer, doesn't listen to his sheikh, he is going to develop an arrogance in himself and pride. We are calling from this member, from this podium, to everyone in tariqats, in tasawwuf, leave your arrogance and come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what he did, Khidr alayhi salam, he opened a hole for the boat to sink. Means I am sinking your ego. I am opening a hole in your ego, in your bad desires, in order that you go clean to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If I don't open that hole to take away your ego, there is a peace is waiting for all of us. That king who is waiting on the other side will take them hostage and will take the boat. So when I am sinking the boat, he will not take them. That is Iblis waiting for us to fall into a mistake. And Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, he didn't explain to him that because this is later. But he said, خرقت السفينة قال أتغرق أهلها أتغرقها. In any case it will come. So the child قال إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا. You cannot be patient with me. I cannot take you after the boat. He said, try me another time. فوجد غلاما فقتل. They found a child, they killed him. He killed him. Sayyidina Musa didn't like it. But in reality, that child was not a real physical child in the interpretation of Awliya Allah. That child is the self, is the soul that built on it all kind of negative energy that has been put on the self, and it become a deadly person, a negative person in the community. That's why Awliya Allah knows their murid, knows their followers, they look at their hearts, they clean them from within, and the person doesn't know what the Awliya Allah are doing. Then third, فوجد جدارا يريد أن ينقض فأقامه. قال لو شئت لاتخذت عليه أجرا. They saw a wall and they was falling. سيدنا خضر knew that this wall is going to be destroyed and the treasure is going to appear and these two orphanage are going to lose their money from their father. Means here, build your wall in yourself. Build your wall. Don't be arrogant. Who follows you, follows you. Who doesn't follow you, doesn't follow you. We follow our teachers, our masters. Maulana Naqib Hasbi and his son Hassan Hasibullah, and we are Hussein Hasibullah. Why not? We like every sheikh. We like to be like them, to follow them. So he built the wall. Means when you kill yourself, Allah give you power. Kill your ego means Allah give you power to build up back your wall because your treasures are there to take them easily. O Muslims, when you lose the treasure, you get sad. When you lose your peers, there is no sadness, but you cannot live anymore. Because you feel something lost in your life. Jibreel alayhi salam, look, azamatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that rahmah, came to him before Islam. Came, he said to him, ikra, read. And what Prophet said, what am I going to read? And he hugged him, pressured him toward his chest, and he said, read. He said, what am I going to read? They explain it that Prophet, because he is ummi, he doesn't know how to read, so he is waiting the wahi to give him what he has to read. But Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam doesn't know what how to read. He was created nur in Allah's presence. doesn't know what Jibreel wants. But he said to Jibreel in the meaning in Arabic, وَمَا أَنَا بِقَارِ, what you want me to speak about science, technology, that you can find a lot in Holy Quran and in Holy Hadith. What you want me to speak about? I have علوم الأولين والآخرين. What you want me to say? He's looking at us. I'm not making it from myself, no. Because he said, إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَادِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا. When you pass Riyad al-Jannah, means gardens of paradises, sit there with the people. They said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهُ وَمَا رِيَادُ الْجَنَّةِ. What is that Riyad al-Jannah? Is this. This meeting, Zikrullah. When you sit, when people making Zikrullah, these shuyukh saints and all other saints make you to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that when you are in the presence of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of course he is looking at us, he is seeing us. How is he seeing us? Can anyone explain? In judgment day, let's take judgment day. In judgment day, how he can see? They say billions and billions and billions of people. Some awliya, they say Ummatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 400 billion. Ummatul Nabi alone, that Ummatul Ijaba, that they accepted him. Not the rest. The rest, they didn't count them here. 400 billion. How he is going to speak with everyone? Today we cannot speak more than two people maximum in the same time. Prophet is going to know your name, your ancestor, your DNA, everything about you, and is going to mention you and take you within his presence by asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness for his ummah one by one. How he can do that? What kind of power Allah gave to him? What is him? What is him? قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيْهِ. مُحَمَّدٌ بَشَرٌ وَلَيْسَ كَالْبَشَرِ بَلْ هُوَ يَاقُوتَةٌ وَالنَّاسُ كَالْحَجَرِ. Muhammad is a human being, but not like us, not like human beings. That is what? Prophet is what? Prophet is what? The one that has no shadow is what? The one that the sun cannot give him a shadow. He is a subtle creation that Allah created. Is a subtle one. Cannot be seen by only the eyes. If we are able to see, we can see him now. But our eyes are not like the eyes of Sahaba that can see. But not like the eyes of Imams. And not like the eyes of Awliyaullah. Awliyaullah, they see what you cannot see. They hear that what you cannot hear. And not, it is not from us, it is from hadith of Prophet, holy hadith. ما زال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه فإذا أحببته كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به وبصره الذي يبصر به. Until the end of the hadith. I will be as long as my servant approaches me through love. When you pray for him, other than your obligation, you are loving him. I will open on his ears that he can hear things that he no one can hear like him. He can see what people cannot see. Oh Muslim, Awliyaullah, they guide us to the right way. Like a river. Where is the river going to go at the end? To the ocean. Ocean of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We don't say Muhammad is ocean, ocean is not a drop of the ocean of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Awliya Allah, they say, on every letter of Holy Quran, there is 24,000 oceans of knowledge. On every letter. One person one time asked me, Ya Sheikh, how many alif in the Holy Quran? How many alif in the Holy Quran? Anyone knows? How we say we know everything? We don't know. But they know, Awliya Allah, they know. He said 2,800 alif. It was repeated 2,800 times. And alif is the first letter of Allah's name. Always standing. Allah. If you take the alif, what rest? Lillah. Means Allah owns that, owns you. If you take the alif out, the continuation of this name is Lillah, means to Allah everything. If you take the lam out, it will be left Lahu, means everything is for him. If you say Ha, if you take the second Na, left you with Hu. Where he is dumped in the ocean of the absolute nothingness, that no one can see anything from this divine knowledge except Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why it is said by one of the greatest awliya that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala khalaq al-khalq min adamin fa'adam. Allah created creation, whole creation. Allah created them from nothingness, from complete nothing. Gone. They appeared. Then he destroyed them. That moment between kun fayakun, creation of the creation to destruction of the creation, is what we are seeing of our age, 1,400 years now. Is the time that we are living on earth. That is a moment in Allah's time. O Muslims, I will not be too long. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I think there are too many people here. And of course, they cannot do da'wah. But you can do da'wah. So they do the work, you give them barakah by your da'wah. So this is how it works. They give from their own money. Allah said in Holy Quran to Prophet, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً. Take from their wealth a sadaqah for building a trust like what they are building. By force, خُذْ. By order, Allah is giving an order for everyone to give in order that you can build Islam, or how Sahaba, they were helping Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in everything. They gave, Sayyidina Abu Bakr gave all his money. Sayyidina Umar gave half of his money. And Sayyidina Osman gave 7 camels full of golden coins. And Sayyidina Ali, may Allah bless Sayyidina Ali. He was the city of knowledge. Tariqa al-Naqshbandiya came from two sources. I will end with this for people to understand. Tariqa al-Naqshbandiya came from two sources. One, the main source is from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then Prophet has put on the tongue of Sayyidina, it is said that ma sabbahu Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ما صب الله عز وجل في صدري صببته في صدر أبي بكر الصديق. Whatever Allah has poured in my heart, I poured in the heart of Siddiq. That's khafi, hidden zikr. That the Naqshbandiya, most of it is hidden zikr. Because directly from heart to heart. Sayyidina Ali, Prophet gave two, Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and Sayyidina Ali. Sayyidina Ali asked Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was mentioning about Kalimat al-Tawheed, he said, how ya Rasulullah, Allah will be happy with us to say. He says, say La ilaha illallah. He says, how I can say La ilaha illallah? Because I want the secret, means here, how I can say it, anyone can say La ilaha illallah. But I want with it the secret of it. He said, then sit in front of me, on your knees, and I am on my knees. Put your hand on my heart, I put your hand on your heart. And repeat after me, La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, and Sayyidina Ali said, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah. Then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya Ali, you say now, I repeat after you. This is what you call talqin in Arabic. I don't know the English word for it. He said, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha, and Prophet saying, la ilaha illallah, three times. This is how he gave him a zikr al-jahri, the loud zikr. Allahu, Allah haq, la ilaha illallah with loud voice. So Sayyidina Abu Bakr took the hidden one, Sayyidina Ali took the jahri one. Sayyidina Abu Bakr gave two people the secret. Gave Salman al-Farisi or Sayyidina al-Qasim, two. Sayyidina al-Qasim, his son, and Sayyidina Salman al-Farisi, gave two. Sayyidina Ali gave two, gave Sayyidina Hassan al-Basri, and he gave Sayyidina al-Hussein. So Tariqa then continue until today. Sayyidina Khalid al-Baghdadi, one of the greatest sheikhs that went to India and learned Tariqa from there, Naqshbandi, came to the Middle East and spread it in the Middle East, has 299 Khalifa. And all of them around the world. That's why you find the Khalidiyya everywhere. So, mashallah, you're the same tariqah which we are together, Naqshbandiyya. I am standing in front of one of the major pillar of the Naqshbandi order. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them long life. Amen. To keep showing us the way. And give you all of you a long life, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المستغفرين فيا فوزا للمستغفرين أستغفر الله والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
يا رسول الله يا علي زندہ باد نہایت ہی خوبصورت زندہ باد بے پناہ خوبصورت دل میں اتر جانے والا خطاب اللہ اکبر یا رسول اللہ یا رسول اللہ یا رسول اللہ یا رسول اللہ زندہ باد بے پناہ خوبصورت دل میں اتر جانے والے خطاب سے ہمارے قلوب و اذہان کو منور فرما رہے